Very good evening, doctors. On behalf of MSN Labs, I, G. Rajesh, welcome you all for this online live webinar on RIRS basic tips and tricks and medical management of BPH, and in that, Silodosin and not why other 5 apps. And we are very much grateful to Dr. Chandra Mohan for accepting our invitation as a speaker. Dr. Chandra Mohan is from Hyderabad, India. He's from Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital. And we also heartily welcome Dr. Tinaji, head of Department Urology from Lagos University Teaching Hospital from Nigeria. We welcome you all, and also the participants who have joined in this live session. Please utilize this session, and I'm handing over the session to Dr. Chandra Mohan.
Good evening, everybody. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Yeah. I thank once again Rajesh and MSN company for giving this opportunity to talk on RIRS basics and Silodosin, its role in the management of medical management of BPH. I also thank Nijani from Nigeria, who accepted to be as panelist. So with this introduction, I say hi to all the participants. Please feel free to chat and ask your questions. Now let me start the topic. Are you on my screen? We are talking about RIRS basics, tips and tricks. To be brief, I am Dr. Chandra Mohan, Managing Director of Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital, Hyderabad, southern part of India. Now, as you all know, renal stone disease is commonest problem everywhere in urology. Small stones are more often detected. Less than 4 mm stones, no need to treat. Lot of patients will come. More than 10 mm stone, ESW and PCNL are commonly used worldwide. Let it be mini pair, anything. Laser lithotripsy is now used more for stone breaking. Once the homium laser has come, flexible scope has come, RIRS is the current concept. You all know ESWL is done. Majority of the procedure is technician dependent, even though surgeon urologist must do it. But in the entire world, it is done by the technician, except it does not require general anesthesia. The major problem is you should have a good mission, which costs you. And all the fragments have to come down by themselves. For that, stenting may be required sometimes. Again, one more procedure. But honestly speaking, for last 10 years, this procedure is slowly going down. Number of ESWL missions appearing is decreasing. PCNL is very good surgery, very, very good surgery for large stone. Still the standard of care for more than 3 cm stones. Technique of puncturing is the crux. You all might be knowing it is done under SIAM. That is the major disadvantage. So
fire through the needle.
You have to puncture the kidney. You have to get the urine out of it. Maybe ultrasound guided, maybe SIAM guided. In such cases, most of the times you use SIAM. And second thing is, whatever said and done, you pass and dilate the tract. Even if it is 15 French, it is dilatation of the kidney. So bleeding can occur. That's why people are looking for alternative. And one more thing is that every day is not your day. Sometimes you may wrongly go into the tract. Abnormal kidneys may not be done. Now coming to the RIRS, it is definitely advanced technology due to miniaturization of the flexible scopes with laser. Primarily, this concept is in there in upper GI endoscopy, where flexible scopes are repeatedly used for last 50, 80, 90 years probably. The advantage is that you can go to the any part of the kidney. Multiple stones can be dealt at a time. Complete powder can be done with patients. Spot clearance is also possible, like in PCNL. Don't say that spot clearance is not possible if you meticulously do it. Happy that in our part we introduced 10, 12 years back. Now we are doing in children less than 1 year, even 4 months baby also. Siam is less required, radiation is less, no bleeding, no pain, can be used on patients with low dosage of aspirin like 75 mg. Bilaterally it can do simultaneously. Nowadays, big stones may not be there. Small stones are available because ultrasound detects them faster. Stagarns, nephrectomies, they are decreasing. Everybody is becoming educated to get ultrasound done. Ultrasound is cheaper. So less than 2 cm stones are detected more. Blood transfusion, we rarely give it. It's a daycare procedure if you wanted to do a small stone. Some situations, it is the useful procedure. One is, you have done PCNL for a large stone, one small stone is left behind. What will you do? RIRS. ESWL, you have given, they made 4 or 5 pieces. What will you do? RIRS. Pregnancy, you need not use Siam. You put a stent, after 10 days, you go inside, nicely powder. There, RIRS is very useful. Absolutely, Siam free RIRS can be done. Ectopic kidney, not always easy to do ultrasound guided PCN because intestine may come. Children, ESWL and radiation are the concern. Multiple stones small are there. You cannot puncture, you cannot give ESWL to many sites. Horseshoe kidney, patients on anticoagulants, spinal deformities. There are certain indications where RIRS is really useful. This is the basic picture where your flexible scope goes inside and flexes. This is the basic video which shows that the ureteroscopy is done through the, this is a basic thing for a layman. This is not for the urologist. Just to start basics, I am producing this video. Some people really does not have exposure to RIRS. For them, exactly this gives a mental picture what we are going to do it. Because if I showed directly my videos, various sets of videos, it may not be possible to understand. But those who have already done it, this presentation, this video may be too simple. Now you go inside like this, you break the stone and you remove them slowly by, now it is small pieces are made. Now you are passing the basket. After you pass the basket, you open it, you take the piece like this, and all the pieces one by one can be removed from the kidney. This is primarily RIRS. Now coming to the subject, what are the tips and tricks of RIRS? Somebody wants to start RIRS. What scope to buy? How to do without damaging the scope? How to give patient satisfaction about the stone-free rate? How to reduce the complications? These are all the things I am talking in half an hour. Later on, we will talk about Silotrif, that is silodosin, an important drug in the management of the BPH. Now coming to the flexible scope related, what exactly it means is, it's a 75 centimeter approximately, 8 French approximately, all scopes. And it has one basic thing is control body where it is in your hand. One insertion tube, long tube, that is 55 centimeters. And distal part will be flexible like a finger. You can imagine your finger. Finger flexes only in one side, other finger flexes in other side. You have a light connector, everybody knows. You have a deflection control. Brain says down. Here you say your thumb says down, up. Now, what are the tips about the flexible scope? See, practically, there may be 100 scopes. You need not know about 100 scopes. All scopes are same. There will be one hole where you have to pass the laser fiber guide wire basket. That is 3.4 French. In 8 French, half is occupied by the channel which use the accessory instruments. Water also goes through that. So the basic tip is that, how is the tip? Where is the laser fiber comes out? Where is the light comes out? If you see once, enough. Keep flexible iridoscope straight always. Don't bend it. The junction of the body and shaft last 15 centimeter is very, very weak. So when you pass laser fiber, it gets damaged. So keep it straight. Again, junction of the hand and the tube is the second part which can break. Keep it straight, straight, straight. Always insert laser fiber and accessories in straight position. Never do unnecessarily too much. For example, you have this finger, you are flexing. If you flex too much like this, finger will break. Finger will break. Same thing, flexible scope. You pass over the guide wire, it is easy to pass the flexible soap into the kidney. Now you see, this is the tip design of my regular scope. I don't know in various countries what scopes are used. Flex X2 from Coral Starch, P7 from Olympus, and some of the scopes, disposable scopes, Flex XC and V3 digital scopes. Sometimes Wolf company is making Cobra scope. These are common. All of them are roughly 8 to 9 French. Don't bang about the size. The one which goes through the small access sheath is good. Fiber optic is reasonably good. Buy that only. This is the position you have to keep always. Don't bend like this. Don't take the instrument like this. Don't put too many instruments on the flexible scope like this. Don't crush in between the suitcase. See, this is important slide. I'm showing here this 15 centimeter junction, very, very important. That is the commonest when you buy first 50 cases. This is the area which it gets damaged because laser fiber is like knife. It goes there, perforates and damages the scope. When you go for chemical sterilization, liquid seeps into it and unnecessarily gets damaged. Keep the laser fiber standby. Whenever anybody who uses the laser, by chance, if you press your leg inside the flexible scope, it will get damaged. Your assistant, yourself, keep in mind that when the laser fiber is removing, you have to keep in stand. While removing only, you press. After removal, if you press, your eyes may get damaged. But when it is inside the tube, if you press, your scope gets damaged. Eyes are rarely damaged unless you keep very close to it. Nobody will closely see the laser fiber. So when you are removing, don't activate the laser. Keep it in standby. This is the way laser fiber comes out through 3.4 French channel. The basic thing is movements. How to hold the flexible scope is like this. On your fingers, you should hold. On your thumb, you rotate. A person who has large hand, he has to keep oblique. A person short hand, he can keep perpendicular. There are two movements here, external rotation, internal rotation, which moves the scope. External internal rotation is like moving the head. This side, I am seeing this part of it. Moving this side, I am seeing this part of it. Up and down is flexing like this, flexing up. Going front is front and back, front and back. These are the three movements, front and back, left and right, and up and down, like head. When you pass a laser fiber, your movements in the flexible scope goes down very much, not small. That's why inferior calicial stone, if you are doing, go inside with laser fiber and then only decide whether you can do PCNL or RIRS. Don't overestimate, I have gone with flexible scope, I can easily do it. No. With laser fiber, if you can go, yes. Otherwise, you have to take with basket and relocate. Now coming to the patient factors, I told about the flexible scope factors. Now I am talking about the patient, which patient you have to choose in the beginning. First 10 cases, stented patient, URSL done, you take the flexible scope, you go inside, see and come out, so that you don't do any laser lithotripsy, you practice only front, back, up, down, side movements, come out. Young female without any problems is good case, because urethra length in male is long, you may not be able to insert. Single stone less than 1 centimeter is better. Don't take 2 centimeter stone, it is difficult. Avoid recurrent stone formers. They say that you have not removed, you have done off work, that's why I came back again. So select one time or not multiple stone patients. When you go into the ureter, you don't know whether the ureter is good, bad. How will you know? 6 by 7.5 ureteroscope, go inside, see it. If it is nice, then only you go for flexible ureteroscopy. If it is not going at all, why will you go? If your head goes only, you can go into the room. If you are not able to go your head, how can you do movements? No. Initially select upper calyx because you are straight. You need not turn this side. Pelvic stone, you are more or less straight. Ureteric orifice, if you see, in this it is second top, it is wide oval, good. If it is a very narrow like a bottom right, not good. Put a stent and come out. If you see the ureter, three areas narrowing, everybody knows, urologist will know. UPJ is very thin. See here, it is thin. Thin means it can avulse, just break. Here it is thick but small. It can perforate. It won't avulse at the lower end. So dangerous is upper end. Don't put the access sheath. Don't pull the guide wire with the basket forcibly. It will break. Breaking is disaster. Perforation is okay. If you are confused which side you want to go, left, right, up, down, have a Google roadmap, that is RGP. You put some contrast. If you are going right, it will say no, no, left. First 10 cases, 15 cases, when you are driving first time car in a different country, 5-6 times if you travel with a Google map showing the roadmap, then you can easily go to your place. Now, in the patient, if you have an inferior calyceal stone, if you can take it out and put in the upper part, it is easy. Because working like this continuously, your neck will get strained. I keep my computer straight and do it. If I have to do for 1 hour, why will I keep down and do it? So if possible, relocate the stone. Large system is easy for PCNL. Don't bang your head going here and there. In a sea, how can you search small stones? Very difficult. Whereas in a small glass, you can easily search. Large stone, hard stone, not good for RIRS. More than 1000 ounce field units, not good for RIRS. Do under general anesthesia, better. Patient will not be taking breathing. If somebody is moving, how can you go? If somebody is calm, straight, you can go nicely. Large prostate gland, it is very difficult to insert the flexible scope. Keep the tidal volume very low. explain the patient requirement of the staged procedures in all the cases. Now, when you want to relocate the stone like this, stone should be smaller, it should be freely moving, infundibulum should be wide, and you take the stone and put it in the upper calyx. Then you can nicely break the stone. If you have a deep respiration like this, every time your laser fiber go under, touch it. You cannot concentrate. If somebody is moving, you cannot concentrate. So better general anesthesia with a low tidal volume, low respiratory rate. Now, if you have a large prostate, first pass a very stiff guide wire, then pass the access sheath. Now, coming to the flexible ureteroscope related factors, again, I already told, flexion extension, for example, if you flex too much, you will get headache. Laser tip, don't keep too close. You may get damaged your scope. Put a little outside. When you are doing in the beginning, use very low energy. Unnecessarily don't go last length of the machine capacity. If it is 30 watts, don't use 30 watts. 10 watts is sufficient. Avoid high energy with 200 micron laser fiber, because 200 is very thin, like very, very thin. It may break if you use high energy, high frequency, because heat effect. Particularly at the scope junction, if you bend a little bit, that energy will dissipate at the bend part, fat sound will come, and like electrical spark, you will see spot burn of the fiber, waste. Don't push the stone with flexible scope. You try to manipulate like this, your scope may get damaged, but gentle pushing is, once you become 50 cases, you can do that. As soon as case is done, immediately clean the flexible scope with water, no other solution, plain normal saline or water, so that all the blood, encrustations, everything will be cleared. Do not keep the flexible scope more than recommended time, because chemical sterilization will make it stiff. Normally in water nothing will happen. If you put in Cydex, paracetic acid, Paracefe, it will become stiff like a rod. One case, 10 cases, 30 cases, it becomes stiff. 20 minutes means 20 minutes. 40 minutes means 40 minutes. Air drying is mandatory. The day you buy the flexible scope, your theater should have air drying, means air should come through a steel nozzle which can go into the flexible scope like cleaning. You clean the car after everything is cleaned with water, you put air and car will become dry. Like that, flexible scope should be dried. Coming to the laser related issues, whatever machine you buy, no conflicts of interest here. 30 watts is sufficient for RIRS. Use 200 micron laser fiber, not 275, not 350, not 500. 500 will not go. Your scope becomes stiff. High frequency, low energy is preferred for large stone. Low frequency and low energy for small stone. Very high frequency, very high energy, lot of heat is generated, so you may damage the scope. Don't push the laser fiber to the substance of the stone. Don't go into the stone. It will backfire, and then blast sheet will be there in holmium laser. It may get damaged. Whereas in thulium laser, it is not there. Don't thread the laser fiber in a tight cap. When you are threading, if you are in a hurry, it will break. That is the major problem. Keep the laser machine in standby when not in use. Avoid using laser close to the ureteric walls, even if it is low energy. For example, in the ureter, if you are using, touch only the stone, center of the stone, not at the side. If you use at the side, the wall gets damaged unnecessarily, it causes stricture. Up to 100 degrees centigrade temperature can come there. Now, if you see the laser, how in FlexX2 it is coming on the 9 o'clock position, in FlexX here it is coming at 3 o'clock position. this will not make difference because you can move head a little bit like this and do it. But in a diverticular stone where you cannot move head, if laser fiber comes here and here, this part of the stone can be done easily. This part of the stone can be done easily. Like in this slide, I wanted to show again that, see, this is on this side, this is on this side. Laser tip should not be too much outside, should not be too much inside. Too much inside, scope gets damaged. Like this. Too much outside, you will be dangling. Because 3.4 channel is fragment versus dust. You see left side, these are pieces like sand. On the right side, it is like powder. So powder is better than, again, I will show this is important slide. The left side is fragments, right side is powder. We say golden sand in our hospital. Any stone, if you see at the end, it will become like a gold, lost small powder. Then coming to the flexible scope is over, patient factors over, laser factors over. These are tips and tricks. In 1 hour, we cannot cover entire RIRS. We are now another 15 minutes, I will close my RIRS talk. After that, we'll go to the benign prostatic hyperplasia, psilotriph. Irrigation and accessories related issues. Urine culture is mandatory before doing RIRS. Avoid spending more than 1 hour in the surgery. If you are not very good, after 1 hour, stop by clock. Access sheath is used in smaller size. 9 by 11.5 is smallest size available. That is the only thing available. Other smallest that scope will not go. So when you buy 9 by 11, you buy. Access sheath, irrigation pump at fixed pressure, no. Don't use irrigation. People are using only gravity, like any other IV fluid. If not, syringe, slowly you infuse 50 ml. On an average, one RIRS procedure will take 400 to 700 ml of fluid. So in one 500 ml bottle is sufficient. Some people give Lasix also, so that water will come from above. You are doing little bit from below, vision is okay. If the outflow from access sheath is not there, avoid high pressure pushing fluid to have better. Just because you don't see fast fluid, you should not use. It causes disturbance in the pressure and kidney. They cause intravasation and disturbance in the pressure. Now, when you are, this is very important point. When you are passing a laser fiber or any wire, don't stop the irrigation. Large clot in the kidney, if you see, you cannot break with holmium. Stop the procedure. After 15 days, it will lie and go. Next time you go and carefully you do it. This happens when the stent is not placed in the beginning, when the water is going under pressure, when water is not coming, then your capillaries will leak. Your RBC will clot. Once clotting occurs, vision will go. For relocation of stone, two baskets are advised. No conflicts of interest. My experience, N-circle 2.2 French Cook. Second is from Boston Scientific, Dakota basket. Dakota basket is like this. Cook is like this. It's closed. Dakota is open, like a tri-prong. You can hold it, you can release. But holding capacity will be less. But releasing capacity will be good. Whereas N-circle, it can hold, but cannot release so easily. I prefer dust. I'm a duster. I don't go with the stones with the basket again and taking. One time if you want to load, go inside, open. Some other person will open, hold it, take it out, hold it, take it out. It will take minimum 4 minutes. If you want to take 20 stones, it will take 4 into 20, 1 hour only for removal of the stone. In 15 minutes, if you do pop dusting or popcorn, it will become dust. Simple logic that baskets are not used for removal of the stones, only for relocation from inferior calyx to upper calyx. Prefer one guide wire outside the access sheath if you are a junior. One outside, access sheath outside. In between the ureteric wall and access sheath, one guide wire will be there. So if you lose the track, that guide wire will save you to put the stent, to do the RGP, to have an access repeatedly. Kinks will be straightened. Always use UPS with your laser and HD camera. You know, it will cost in Indian rupees around 70,000 rupees. It is a battery which supports up to 5 kV. 5 kV is very less. All TV, monitors, laser will be on. Except Siam, entire theater can be run on 5 kV. With just 60,000, you will never. This comes for 2 years. Battery life is 2 years. Never use maximum energy of the machine for a long time. Continuous usage of the laser fiber decreases the efficiency. For example, laser fiber used. It will also burn. So take it out and cut. Again, it will work fresh. After how much time? Maybe after 20 minutes. How much you have to cut? Half centimeter. How much money you will lose? Nothing. Avoid laser contact with renal mucosa at infundibulum. Disaster can occur. Upper pole. If it is dangling infundibulum, if you touch homium is particularly perforating type, knife type. Large fiber can damage the infundibular vessel also, like in PCNL. It's very difficult to control bleeding in RIRS. Stop and come out. So never give chance. Don't touch the mucosa at all. Do gentle RGP and ureteroscopy at the end of the procedure. You feel happy that I have not damaged anything. I have not done intrarenal reflux. I have not done intravesical extravasation. Then put a stent and come out. If bleeding is there, for example, you put a Foley's catheter, red color urine is coming, you put saline and it will be flushed. So that for 1 hour, 2 hours, like in TURP, drop by drop irrigation, you clean so that blood and with water will come out and clots will not form. Hematuria is common in RIRS. Gentle relook in a case of a large stone burden after 2 weeks is worth. Now, this is one method of access sheath insertion we follow always. 4x6.5 ureteroscope snugly fits into the access sheath. So we pass the scope first. Two guide wires are there here. We are going with scope, not blindly with Siam. So that Siam is not required. One guide wire. See, automatically sheath has gone inside. You can move it. You can see whether the ureter is damaged or not. This is nothing but visual obturator technique. Now see, this is the way you flush before you insert the flexible scope to remove the air bubbles. Air bubbles will be there in the flexible scope. Water should be coming out clearly like this. Then your vision will be very good. If water is going, if it is not coming out, how will the vision will be good in TURP or RIRS? No way. Irrigation should be continuous inflow and outflow. See, if you keep the laser fiber too much outside, it will be dangling. You can't focus. It's like writing with a pen holding at the tip. If you want to write very nicely, you have to hold the pen at the tip. Now, this is the laser fiber which is correct. 1/4 of the screen laser fiber should be there so that you can nicely paint the stone. If you want to cut or trim, general blade is okay. No need for advanced equipment or company made only. But if you have it, use the company removal of the. First of all, removing of the outer blue one is not required. Many have confirmed. You can directly use. Only advantage is that you can see separately white one, which is not much useful. Now you see here, when laser fiber is hitting the mucosa, it may cause bleeding like this. So don't touch and perforate the mucosa. Now see, so much powder is formed, it causes vision obscuration and viril pool effect. How to avoid this? You take the scope outside repeatedly like this, then all the powder will come out. Now, how to make RIRS cost of, everybody says it is costly, costly, costly. PCNL is 5 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes. It's not like that. Today, we have done 22 mm with thulium fiber laser in 14 minutes. If you have a high wattage laser, once you get experience, you can finish in less than 30 minutes around 1.5 centimeter, 2 centimeter stones. Then how can it be long taking time? Only first 50 cases, you learn it properly and then go. Now, size should be small in the beginning. Location should not be in the inferior calyx. Less hard stone. Don't take multiple stones. Expertise of the surgeon is important. Where you are working is also important. Your own hospital, I have my own hospital. Preeti Hospital is my own. I can reduce the charge, I can increase the charge. If you are in corporate, you have to be careful. Tell the patient that 1 hour charges are this much. Second time if you come this much. Third time if you come this much. Then it is cost effective. There are technical aspects to improve the results is access sheath better to use. Without SIAM also it can be inserted. Do dust. If upper uretric stone is there, push it, relocate to a straight calyx and do it. Then results are better. Now here I am using access sheath with SIAM. This is commonly used over the guide wire. You pass the access sheath, slowly it goes up and keep watching on the CM. The other method is visual obturator method by 4x6.5 uretroscope. We use 3.5 French stent. This is a small stent which goes through the 6x7.5 uretroscope. Small stents causes less irritation. Without CM, you can put it. See? In the uretroscope, it is going closed end. Guide wire is the pusher. This is uretroscope. I am threading it. The end guide wire is the pusher. Now I am going into the urethra. I will go into the kidney or upper ureter. Now I will push. See, watch the video. This is very important. Smaller the stent. See, now I am in the ureter. Now I am pushing the stent with. I engage the flexible scope into the ureter, no problem. Routinely you do it. Now I push the stent. Stent will come into the ureter. It will go directly. See, this is the uretric lumen after the RIRS. So that in corporate you can avoid using the CM. They charge 5 to 10,000 Indian rupees. Now you are pushing the stent under vision. It is going into the kidney. Once it comes out like this, you push against the wall of the bladder and take out the guide wire and the stent coiled inside. There is no need to confirm. Definitely it will go up only unless it is a stricture. You have already done it. How the stricture will be there? You need not confirm like this. Or 5 second snapshot you can take. Pushback RIRS. Whenever you have a stone in the ureter, you push it. Now you are going and suddenly stone is seen. Don't do laser there. Push. It has gone up. Now you do a formal RIRS. That is better so that stricture is not formed. Or PCNL. Now thulium fiber laser. It is not thulium. See how you are painting slowly. You move. Surface. You should have patience in RIRS. Slowly you keep on moving. It will become powder. Whether it is holmium or thulium, both are same for low wattage RIRS. Because ultimately if you use low energy, medium frequency, it will nicely dust like this. You think that it will take a lot of time. No, slowly the volume gets reduced. Don't reduce the surface area. You keep on doing painting on the surface. Volume will be reduced. It's like removing one paper of the book. One paper you remove. First time you think that too many papers are there. As you come in the end, only one paper will be there. You can easily tear it off. lower pole angles, large impacted stone, you see here how to do. If it is large impacted stone, if you basket it, it may get struck. So don't basket the large impacted stones. Now with this, my talk is over on RIRS. I have taken 45 minutes time. I started at 7:05. Now it is 7:45. I will quickly roll slides where after coming expertise, you can do no videos I will show or little video I will show. In 5 minutes, I will close the RIRS talk. Then we will go to Silotrif. Pediatric patients we are doing. Our smallest baby is 4 months. This is the smallest baby RIRS we have done. Very small penis. Suprapubically, we are aspirating with catheter. We have used maneuvers to do ureteroscopy. This is a fast video. You can see here. This is the CT. This patient presented with anuria. Many times in Indians, we have shown this, but these are rare. This is the world's smallest baby to undergo bilateral RIRS. Once you get experience, it is not very difficult because in children, ureter behaves well. But doing in such small children is definitely difficult. You have to be careful. Do RGP, do guide wires. This ureter is kinking. Then pass the guide wires. Then aspirate like this. See, this is slipping. Again, you go inside. This is inside the kidney. See the stone properly and break the stone. See, this is the stone. You keep on breaking with, you cannot do dusting here. See, large stone. And this is RGP at the end. Now I am doing opposite side. Opposite side stones are there. Some movements, awkward movements are required. This is the stone in the calyx. Now all the big stone in the other calyx, multiple stones. Now post-operative CT, normal. Normal. The stone has come calcium and ammonium hydrogen urate mixed. In India, a low socioeconomic patients, uric acid stones are common. 24-hour urinary showed hyperuricosuria. We have made it published in Elsevier General Urology this year. RIRS in obese patient, you see 150 kg. Whether you are 100 kg, 50 kg, 150 kg, urethra is same, ureter is same, thank God. Penis does not have fat. So you can easily do. See, this is the video you are going inside. Ectopic kidney. This is in the lower part. You see, we are passing the stone here in the ectopic kidney. Small access sheath length you have to use. Water is coming. Nicely big stone. We are using Flexex C. After that, we used P7 and continuously you make powder vertical like that. In ectopic kidneys, too much space will not be there. You have to carefully keep on powdering. Now multiple stones, you see multiple stones, RIRS in solitary kidney, see big stone. This is very large stone, 4-5 centimeter. This is a very, you should not attempt casually these cases. 100 watts laser is essential. See, now you are doing all around the lasing. Multiple settings are required, 2-3 times. Then it is after first setting, this is at the completion of the procedure. Now this is kyphoscoliosis, small kid. See how it is spine. You cannot do PCNL easily, but in RIRS, small stone, 5 minutes, it will be finished. It is an unedited video, calcium oxalate dihydrate, hardly any time it is required. Rotational anomaly. See, kidney is 180 degrees rotated here, no problem. You enter from the penile urethra, you are female urethra, you go to the destination by passing. You need not see bowel, you need not see the vessel, you need not see the parenchyma, you need not see the skin also. Entry point and exit point are same, urethra, kidney. Like this, it goes easily. Once you go inside, 100 videos if you see also, same surgery, painting, painting, painting. Now, crossed ectopic kidney, post-pyelolithotomy, post-nephrolithotomy, post-PCNL, residual stone. See how the flexible scope is bending. See the this video post-operatively, it is completely cleared. Now, crossed only ectopic kidney, small stone. How can you do LAP? How can you do PCNL? How can you do ureterolithotomy? It may go inside. But it is removed easily like this. See, RGP, it is going opposite side, scope goes to opposite side easily, and then pick up the stone and make powder. See, scope is going opposite side. No problem. As long as you have tube tunnel like a car, you can go this side or that side, wherever you want, you can go. Post op CT is car normal. Horseshoe kidney. We have done large stones in children. This is a large stone. See the picture, see the stone, see the RGP, very difficult for PCNL. You can go inside and definitely do like this. See, the stone is seen, same painting, painting, painting. So bilateral stones, 10 stones this side, 10 stones this side. You go inside, see both the sides, you can do same setting like this. See, on this side, very, very small. How will you do PCNL? How will you do ESWL in this case? Happily, you go, you stent before so that no pressure rise. You spend some time, half an hour here, half an hour here, slowly make powder. This is complete clearance. See, hardly one speck is seen. Now, RIR assisted PCNL, you have one upper calyx, you have one lower calyx. You do, see, this is upper calyx, this is lower calyx. You bring the upper calyx stone to lower calyx and do PCNL. Now I'm bringing down. Like ECARS has come now, supine PCNL. Now see, now in one puncture, everything come out. No second punctures. In future, multiple puncture concepts may not be there with the flexible uretroscopy, even in large stones. Heart-shaped stone, you have done PCNL, it slipped into the other stone, other part. Like this, it has gone. You put a stent while doing PCNL, one piece has gone into bifid system. Then you can do RIRS after 15 days. No unnecessary supracostal puncture, no unnecessary pleura injury. You use straight flexible scope in a straight upper part, finish. Diverticular stone like this can be approached. Sometimes they are very easy, you can easily go inside. Last case is a difficult case, large stone in the ectopic kidney.
This is a very big stone. History of
very big stone. You are going inside, flexible scope, see, like a snake it is going. I cannot do flexible scope, I did only half. Now I have to do big stone, it is not possible. Then laparoscopy is done. You do laparoscopy, you remove the bowel, you remove the intestine, you remove the sigmoid colon, go to the pelvis like this separate, you take the needle, you are using flexible scope to guide the needle. One side you lights off and see where you are to puncture. Go to the superior most so that you can remove all these stones. See, I am dipping with my finger. There only you puncture so that any vessel will not come. And now you punctured. See, you are puncturing under vision. See, under vision you are puncturing. And same thing will be seen in the flexible scope part also. See here, I am puncturing. See, that needle has come here. You are very safe. You pass the guide wire, then you do the dilatation. Then like this in PCNL, you do the dilatation. You go inside, insert the access sheath. At the end, big, big stones are there. You cannot do RIRS. Sometimes this is the flexible scope from below. You can see each other. Now, this is a big stone by the side in the inferior calyx. So happily, you remove it. So now you take out and suture the small rent and put stent, no nephrostomy, and close the peritoneum. You should have some suturing skills. So sometimes laparoscopy is required, PCNL is required, RIRS is required. One should know everything, and close this peritoneum, it is easy. So with this, I thank you. Now we will go to the psilocin talk. So now I have taken already 45 to 50 minutes. Now I will spare 15 minutes because my talk is 1 hour. I thank once again MSN. It is my conflict of interest in this presentation because it is sponsored by MSN. I will be talking about psilotrif in this talk. You know, I will take a sip of water before I start this talk. Now, when you see the prostate gland, you all know these are basic slides. No need to unnecessarily go into the depth. small prostate, big prostate. Big prostate causes obstruction of the urethra, like a small peanut, like a large orange. It is very common. Nigeria, Arabia, South Africa, India, America, China, prostate is as long as you are more than 40, 50 years, men, prostate will be there. Age is increasing, prostate is increasing, prostate cancer, BPH, both will increase in the future. Symptoms, all you know, frequency, urgency, nocturia, hesitancy, stream, weak, intermittency, incomplete emptying. Daily we will ask these questions. 7 questions you ask, those who are obstructive, those who are irritative, medical management is the first option. Unless 2 times retention, stone formed, renal failure, bilateral hydroureteronephrosis, recurrent patient not willing for medicine anymore. Diagnosis, clinical examination, PSA, all theory, I don't want to go in detail. Impact on the patient, headache, night time you have to pass 2 times, 3 times, patients are unhappy. Every patient after 60 years has to wake up 1 time, mostly. If you are not waking up, great. After 70, 2 times. Even 2 times, it disturbs sleep. Frequency, urgency is the most important. So many treatments are available. You all know that. Alpha blockers are the primary line. After that, 5 alpha reductase inhibitors are secondary one. In alpha blocker medical management, common thing is alpha blockers are there entire body. Alpha 1, A, B, C, some in the bladder, some in the vessels, somewhere in the brain. So any drug which acts only on alpha 1, A highly in the bladder neck is a good drug. Selective alpha blocker, that is Cilnidocaine and Cilotriv. Now, this Cilotriv comes in 4 mg capsule, 8 mg capsule. Nobody wants this diagram. What will you do with this chemistry? Nothing. 4 mg, 8 mg Cilotriv, you remember. Pharmacokinetics, if you take empty stomach, fast action, orthostatic hypotension may come, suddenly you may fall. Take with food, slowly it acts, 24 hours it acts, problem solved. All alpha blockers causes, in fact, Cilotriv causes less. Side effects, dizziness, diarrhea, nasal congestion, retrograde ejaculation. I have seen only some patients retrograde ejaculation. Many patients, no complaints with Cilotriv. 4 mg, 8 mg approved. If you have renal failure, no use. Many drugs, no use. Advantages over other therapies with Cilotriv are rapid onset. Frequency urgency also improves naturally Cilnidocaine. Safer in cardiac patient. Lot of people used to say QT prolonged that. At 4 mg, 8 mg, it is not reported. Reduced nighttime getting up, improved bladder storage, improved quality of life. See these slides, main important is Cilnidocaine, Cilotriv is. It acts for maximum period of T-max is 4 hours. So you will get happily maximum effect in less time and prolonged effect. It is a very, very selective alpha-1A blocker. Superiority over 5 alpha reductase is, you know, once you take glutathione, sexual function will come down. So young patients, this is a almost drug of choice nowadays, Cilotriv. Why Cilnidocaine? Again, selectivity, sustained efficacy, safety. Alpha-1A on the left side of this slide, we want only there to function. It is more with 162 times is to 1 is Cilnidocaine. There is no need to mention anything than this. That's why alfuzosin is used in younger patients. Cilotriv is used in older patients. So 63% and BPH tissue, 85% distribution is there, alpha-1A blocker. So uniquely selective alpha-1A blocker, 200 times higher affinity is there. Then sustained efficacy. It starts after 4 hours and then full day, it will be there. The most important point in Cilotriv is you will also get symptoms relief irritative. Everybody knows that if obstruction is relieved, bladder also feels happy. No, I am emptying. My irritative symptoms also can be decreased. Safety, multiple trials have been done. QT prolonged interval and deaths are very, very, very rare unless patient has some conduction abnormalities. Now, the data with 8 mg has proved does not affect cardiac repolarization because of the potassium and sodium imbalance. It is not reported. Multiple trials have been there like this. These are given by company to me. I have not done these studies, but company studies I am quoting. They told that it is very, very, very safe. And International Journal of Urology 2010 also, this is published. So conclusion, it is very selective, highly selective. Post hoc analysis have shown that more efficacious than tamsulosin, minimal cardiovascular effects, less retrograde ejaculation, can co-prescribe with PDE5 inhibitor easily. That's why Siletriv is more. IPSS score improvement as well as Qmax improvement as well as complications, all these studies have shown that this has shown a lot of good effect. So with this, I say that Silodosin in the form of Silotrif is also good, very good, and it giving good results. I usually combine with the Dutasteride in large prostates. In small prostate, I use directly Silodosin. We have steroid because I am concluding. This steroid mission is useful for RIRS, but costly. Initially, Paracef chemical sterilization is sufficient. We have our team, Dr. Ramakrishna, who is senior, instrumental in developing the Preeti Hospital. Dr. Siddhilinga Swami is taking care of our second hospital in BHEL. Dr. Manas is also taking care of second hospital. Dr. Saundarya and Dr. Hemnath, being husband and wife urologists, are doing a lot of help and academic activity to me in making these presentations. And two more persons recently completed the fellowship. Dr. Arjun and Dr. Rakesh have left the Preeti Hospital, and I wish all them best in their future. Now, you can see all the unedited videos. Whatever I am talking is only positive points. Some amount of negatives also will be there. Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital has a YouTube where unedited videos, complications are also kept. You can watch it and learn it. You can give feedback to us. Every fourth Saturday in a month, fourth Saturday, we conduct live session. Now it is Corona time. We are not doing once Corona is over. You can come even from South Africa. You call, you give email to us. You take the number from MSN company Rajesh and keep in touch with us. Sharing knowledge is the only way we can help the future generations, including our children and grandchildren. These are the two hospitals where I am working as the MD. We are doing high volume work, laparoscopy and RIRS. We have a great team of nephrology, urology, cardiology. I thank you once again, all the speakers, all the participants, and our Nigerian urologist Aljin and the MSN entire team. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity. We will go to the chat and ask the questions and quickly finish the session as it is the end of the day for us in India. Thank you very much. Over to Rajesh. Can I close the screen? Yes. I am not able to hear.
Sorry, sir. I'm Dipankar. I see, sir. I'm Dipankar from MSN. I see yes, there sir. Are some...
yeah. Sorry, I did not mention your name. You are instrumental in conducting this webinar. Thank you very much, Dipankar.
Thank you very much, sir. It's my pleasure. Sir, there are some questions in the chat. Chat. And I see Dr. Tijani is there as a senior.
Hello, sir. Tijani, sir. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, if we can address some of the questions which are there in the chat section.
Yeah. So I am going to the chat section. I will go from the first. I will come. Yes. This is a question from Majrook. Hi, CM sir. Your contagious RIRS passion spreads across nations more. Again, yesterday's rapid fire on RIRS infants was another. Okay. Thank you, Majrook. A warm welcome to distinguished urologists in Nigeria. Thank you, Adams. Sani, we are patiently waiting for the network problem, no problem. Toby, thank you for welcoming all. Ajok, thank you for welcoming from West and East. Nuhu Dakam cannot see presenter, only slides. You can see me now. Dr. Rakesh, if DJ stent is not possible due to impaction and scopy is not available due to narrow lumen, what are the options? Very good question. You do RGP. If you feel that it is very tight, don't do RIRS. If you feel that guide wire is not going, something is very wrong, ultrasound guided PCN, go anti-grade, come from above, from kidney into the ureter and take out the stone. Next, Dr. Rikesh, answer is over. How will get RIRS videos, please? Mesely gabrielisi. You go to Preeti Urology and Kidney Hospital, you search RIRS, hundreds of videos are there, hundreds. Even today's presentation, you can have tomorrow in my video, in my YouTube. Next, Hagaji Irga, what other benefits we get from psilocybin other than symptomatic relief, better than alpha reductase inhibitor? Psilocybin is the first choice as of now for both irritative and voiding symptoms. If the gland is very large, then only we will go for finasteride or dutasteride. So primarily you have to use psilocybin. After that, you add the dutasteride. Now coming to the Akash Poor Network, sorry, Jan Naining Sit. Thank you for your interesting basic concept. Thank you very much, Jan. Sani, can RIRS be done without CM? Yes, very important question. You put a stent. If stent goes easily like in pregnancy, that means ureter is good. That means you can go. So you pass a guide wire. I told a technique with a ureteroscope inside the access sheath and go inside. After that, over the guide wire, you go into the kidney. If it is single stone, why should you see in the CM? Finish it. No problem. Thank you, Sunny. I think we addressed all the questions. If anybody wants to ask questions, put in chat. Somebody is typing from Shema. Meanwhile, Tess Fahan is also, can RIRS be done without CM, is addressed already. Chima is typing. We will wait for 5 minutes. Two people are typing, Mesely and Chima. Dr. Govind Goyal. Meanwhile, Nijil sir, you can, from Nigeria, you can ask any question, sir.
Dr. Tijani, I shall request you, if you can also address some of the queries.
Tijani, sir.
Sir, your mic is muted. Dr. Tijani, I think your mic is muted, sir. Yes, I think now it's okay.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. We can hear you now. Yes, we can hear you.
I just want to pass a comment on our experience with psilocybin. It's relatively new in Nigeria anyway. My personal experience with it was, previous experience was with patients who had traveled and had brought the drugs. What we have noticed particularly is that a lot of patients who had failed response to tamsulosin, alfusosin, who otherwise will have ended up with surgery, actually doing well with psilocybin. And although I've not really done a lot of research on looking at studies that have compared patients who had failed therapy to one alpha 1 blocker going to another alpha 1 blocker. I don't know what your experience is like or whether you are aware of any publication, but from what we have seen, I've seen a lot of patients who had failed response to tamsulosin and are responding well to psilocybin.
My experience with psilocybin, I used tamsulosin 3-4 years back liberally. Now, last 2-3 years, what I feel is that slightly more efficacious is psilocybin, honestly. Slowly, all the urologists are shifting from tamsulosin to psilocybin. That is true, because or symptom relief is slightly better with psilocybin.
Okay.
Slightly better with psilocybin.
Okay.
What is your experience, Tijani?
Yeah, that's what you know. Psilocybin is relatively new in Nigeria. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But what I'm saying is that probably because of cost issues, a lot of patients tend to start with psilocybin.
Correct.
My experience here is that a lot of patients who had failed in their response to psilocybin have tended to do well with psilocybin.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what we have seen here. Patients who were not doing well with psilocybin, you change to psilocybin and they do very well.
Very well. That is for sure.
Yes.
Thank you. Any questions you want to address, Rajesh, or anything you want to have any doubts? Some people are typing, but it's taking time. We can spend another 3-4 minutes, no problem. We finished in right time, not even exactly 7:05. We started 8:05 now. Is it okay, Tijani, waiting for another 2 minutes?
Yes, let me ask. I want to ask you a question on the stone. What's your residual stone rate after IRS?
Average is 15 to 10%. 85% it will be cleared. But however best you do, 10 out of 100 will have small stones. That is there.
Okay. And now, what's your choice? Do you, although I missed part of the presentation, do you fragment the stones or you just vaporize the stones?
Vaporize, powder, as much as possible powder. The last piece also, if you powder, results will be better. So it's a patience.
Okay. Thank you. Are there times that you consider blasting? That's instead of powder. Are there times you prefer fragmenting?
If you fragment, it is a loss. So don't try to make pieces in the beginning. Last part, if you make, then you can use popcorn. In the beginning, only if you make pieces, you'll go here and there, and one piece will miss. Okay. That causes SFR very low.
Okay,
so
thank you.
Try to make powder with low energy, low frequency for less than 1.5. It will take less than 1 hour. Good result.
Okay, thank you.
Those who want to start RIRS, what I wanted to say is never take more than 1 centimeter. And don't try to spend too much time in the inferior calician stone. If you bend and do a lot of work, your scope will break. It is costly equipment. Then you lose interest. And then once scope is broken in the first 50 cases, it is not good. That is one point I want to mention. And also one more thing, you should be good in PCNL. For example, if RIRS fails, tell the patient attendance that PCNL can be done. Because if RIRS is difficult, PCNL is easy. Very inferior calcium stone, you can easily do PCNL. So that makes a difference. Should we, what do you say? So I am not able to see after the Fanny message. A lot of people are typing, but network is, did you get any message?
No, sir. There is no message after that, sir. Last message is of Fanny. After that, there is no message.
Yeah. Anything comments you wanted to, how is the psilocybin usage across other than India, Deepankar? What is your experience?
Sir, we have as I am looking after West Africa as a cluster head, I can share with you for the West Africa. Nigeria, we are the first to introduce psilocybin in the market, Psilotrif. And we have got a very fabulous response here. Senior doctors, like even Dr. Tijani is one of the best taker of Psilotrif. He is prescribing, he is a very good prescriber. As well as some other part of Nigeria also, it has been taken in a very good way, sir. There are some concerns, but as Dr. Tijani said, for cost and all. But being in MSM, sir, even this, we have brought in Nigerian market at a very affordable cost. And for on cost angle also, it is well accepted. Then in Ivory Coast, we have launched, sir, very recently, 3-4 months back, we have launched. And in Ivory Coast also, doctors have really taken up this molecule very nicely. Urologists are highly appreciative about this molecule. In fact, they are also, we are the first company to launch silodosin in the market.
Great. I congratulate for that. There is one question which has come. Dr. Gauriya, sir, you mentioned that if there is big hematoma, we need to resume RIRS after 15 days. If you are experienced, what is the time frame for permanent kidney damage in case of complete obstruction? Honestly speaking, clot will not obstruct. Clot does not cause damage to the kidney. Only stone can obstruct and damage. That depends on various factors. If the urine is coming down little bit, damage won't occur. If the opposite kidney is normal, damage occurs fast. So complete obstruction, if you are tied the ureter, then it can damage occurs in 6 weeks, complete damage. But clot will not cause damage. This is the answer for your question, Gauriya. And Yusuf Nahabu, how about difficulty of operation post silodosin for BPH compared to people that have not taken the drug? I must tell two things here. If you use silodosin for RIRS, it is going to help you because ureter may dilate. Some studies have proven. I don't have much experience, but if you want to try, one day before also, ureter may become little bit loose because naturally sphincter is muscle, so it will become loosened. That is one point. Second point is, if you use silotrip for the BPH, you may not get vascularity decreased. If you add dutasteride, then only volume will come down. So silodosin silotrip is only for alpha blocker relaxation, not to help for the TURP. Now coming to the next, I think your answer is addressed, Yusuf. And now Chima, as ultimately I got the question from Chima, good response with silodosin, but cost is a problem. How can we reduce the cost? Now Deepankar and Rajesh will put efforts to reduce the cost globally. It is pretty tough. For them also, let's hope it will come down in the future and you will use it more often for your patients. Now, Dr. Govind Goyal, is there any significant hypotensive effect of silodosin? I have not seen any patient falling. I have seen with alfuzosin, but not with tamsulosin and silodosin. They are selective. The main advantage of silodosin is you won't get hypotension. Now, Dr. Kumar Kupuswamy, super presentation, Dr. Chandramohan. Thank you. Thank you, Kumar, sir, for your comments. So I think we should conclude the session now. What do you say, Tijani, sir?
Yeah, I think so. I'm sure it will be late in India right now. Yes.
Yeah. No, it is okay. 9 o'clock in the night, not too late, but still questions are coming, but we should have a time limit. I can answer those questions later on to them personally.
Yeah,
is it okay, Deepankar?
Yes, sir. I think that will be perfectly okay. What I can suggest that our respective team members will meet all the doctors who have attended this program, and they will take their questions, whatsoever queries are there, they can take it, and then we can liaise with our office at Hyderabad, and those questions we can take it to you, and from there we can get the response and we can share with them. I think that will be very nice, sir. In that way, we have their email ID as well. So then they can contact you as well, and we can also liaise to it.
You can give my email ID as well as phone number to urologists. No problem. We are already ready to exchange the knowledge. Thank you.
I think that will be
better. So thank you, Tijani, sir. Thank you, Deepankar. Thank you, Rajesh.
Sir, on behalf of MSN, I would also like to thank all the all my doctors, esteemed doctors, who have time in this COVID situation.
Your voice is breaking, Deepankar.
Sir, I am audible now. Hello, am I audible now?
Yes. Yes,
sir. On behalf of MSN, I would like to thank all the doctors who have taken their time to attend this webinar on a subject which is very relevant to our countries, specific countries. Specifically, sir, I would like to here thank Dr. Mohan, Dr. Chand Mohan from India, who in fact who has taken his time and shared his wisdom on this subject to doctors of Africa and other places as well. I would also like to thank Dr. Tijani, with whom I have personal interaction, and in fact, you will be happy to know, sir, that he chaired one of our CME just 2 months back here in Lagos on this subject. And this COVID situation, as we know, world over, it is everybody is in fix that what to do. But then also doctors, as you are the solution giver here, sir. You people are looking at you for all the solutions right now. And we, MSN, on behalf of MSN, we can say that we are also trying to take part into it by providing such type of platform where sharing of ideas, sharing of knowledge can take place, and which can play a vital role in benefiting of people in different, in global forum. Sir, with this, I want to thank all of you, Dr. Mohan, Dr. Tijani, and all our attendants. Thank you very much, sir.